children, welcome to our grammar class. So before we begin our class, we'll have a silent prayer. So all of you, close your eyes. Yes. So what we studied in the last class? Yeah, we studied what are verbs, what are modal verbs, isn't it? And we studied different types of modal verbs, different modal verbs, that is can, could, may, could, might, isn't it? Can, these all are what? Yeah, modal verbs. Yeah, modal verbs of ability, modal verbs for permission, isn't it? Next we are going to study what is a sentence, that is what is a sentence and what are the parts of a sentence. So before that, what is a sentence? Yeah, a sentence is a group of words that put together to make that makes a sense, isn't it? Yes. And a sentence have three parts. A sentence have three parts. That is subject, verb, object. Subject, verb, object. So what is a subject? A subject means what? Yeah, a subject means it is what or whom the sentence is about. That is, who's performing an action. Who performs the action in the sentence. That is called a subject. Who performs the action. It's called a subject. Then verb means what? Verb means the action. The activity or action that is taking part. Then object. Object means what? Whoever or whatever receives the action. That is, receives the action. That is called object. So, a sentence have three parts. That is, subject, verb, object. Understood? So, subject, who is performing the action. Who performs the action is called the subject. Verb means the action. That is, what the action is taking place. That is called the verb. And the object means whoever or whatever receives the action. That is called object. Okay. So, we will see some examples. So, then we will understand what it is. Okay. Now, look at these examples. The snake caught the frog. The snake caught the frog. He paints posters. He paints posters. My sister is writing a novel. He was playing the guitar. In the first sentence, the snake caught the frog. Here, which is the subject here? Which is the subject? Who performs the action here? It's the snake, isn't it? The snake is performing the action. So, snake is what? Snake is the subject. Snake is the subject. So here what action is taking place? Caught, isn't it? Caught. So it is the verb. And the object. Who receives the action? It is the frog. So it is the object. Understood? The snake. Snake means it is the subject. Then caught is the verb and frog is the object. Understood? So, subject means it is who performs the action and verb means it is the action taking place and object means who receives the action. Understood? Next sentence. He paints posters. He paints posters. Here he is what? He is the subject. He is performing the action. Then, what is the action taking place here? Paints, isn't it? So, that is the verb and here posters is what? It is the object. Understood? Next, my sister is writing a novel. My sister is writing a novel. So, here, which is the subject here? Novel is the subject here? No. Who is performing the action? Yeah, my sister. So, this is the subject. Then, what is the verb here? What is the action taking place? It's writing. Isn't it? The And that is the verb. And novel is the object. Understood? Next, he was playing the guitar. So, he is what? He is the subject. And playing is the verb. And guitar is the object. Understood? So, the sentences having three parts, that is the subject, verb, object. So, subject means who performs the action, and verb means the activity or the action going on of a subject. Then, object means who receives the action. Understood, children? So, what is subject, verb, object? Yes. Now, we'll move on to subject and predicate. So, what is subject and what is predicate? Next, we are going to study what is a subject and a predicate. So, the sentence can be separated into two parts. That is subject and predicate. I think we have already studied subject and predicate, isn't it? So, the sentence is separated into two parts. That is the subject and the predicate. So, what is the subject? Subject, the thing or a person that we are talking about. So, that is a subject. It can be a thing or a person that we are talking about. Understood? Then, what is a predicate? Predicate means something more about that person or a thing. We are telling something more about that person. Understood? That is the subject is or does. A subject is or something he does. It always begins with the verb. Understood? For example, my family went to the zoo. My family went to the zoo. Here, what is the subject here? What we are talking about? We are talking about the family, isn't it? They went to the zoo. Understood? So, we are talking more about that person or a thing. That is about the family. So, what we are talking about, that is went to the zoo. Here, went is what? Went is verb. Understood? So, predicate begins with the verb. So, here my family is the subject and went to the zoo is the predicate. Understood? So, here my family is the subject and went to the zoo is predicate. Understood? Next sentence. Sarvan and I are going to the library. Sarvan and I are going to the library. Here, who's the subject here? Subject is Sarvan and I is the subject, isn't it? And are going to the zoo is what? Going to the library is what? Is the predicate. Understood? Next sentence. The lion chased the mouse. So here, which is the subject here? Subject is what? Lion. Isn't it? Then, chase the mouse is predicate. Here, chased is the verb. And the mouse is the object. So, chase the mouse is the predicate. The monkey wore red caps. Here, who is the subject here? Is the monkey. We are talking about monkey, isn't it? Yeah. So, monkey is the subject. And wore red caps is the predicate. So, predicate always begins with the verb. So, here verb is what? Wore. So, wore red cap is the predicate. So, understood? So, a sentence have two parts, that is the subject and the predicate. So, subject is a thing or a person that we are talking about. And predicate, predicate is something more about that person or a thing. That is a person is or does. Understood? Here, my family went to the zoo. My family is the subject and went to the zoo is the predicate. Predicate always begins with the verb. Understood, children? Yes. So, we studied subject, verb, object and also the subject and the predicate. Understood? So, that's all for this day. So, you can take your textbook. You can take page number 62. There, I told you to do the exercise, isn't it? That is exercise number 1 and 2. So, you can complete exercise 3 and exercise 4. Okay. 4 and 5 you can complete. Isn't it? So, do that exercise. Complete it for the next class. Okay. So, thank you children. Have a great day.